Hi, so today we're in our barley trial field. This is one of four that we've done down here with this farmer. And what we've done here is trial a different type of drill. So it's a min-till drill called a Mzuri strip tillage drill. And we've done a couple of different plots, comparing it to a standard combination drill that the farmer would tend to use. And also trialing different cultivation practices pre-drilling. So this is a crop of spring barley. This field was previously grass, which was a long-term lay. And then it went into winter wheat last year. And then spring barley this year, following on from a bare winter where it was left just in stubbles. So as you can see, we've got the barley crop. Now this one, looking at the bottom, is the crop drilled with a combination drill because it's quite close together. And then if you go further over here, you can tell. And this one is the one that we've drilled with the Mzuri drill because it's got wide coulters, so it's placed further apart. Now the biggest difference we can tell with the two crops is that the ears are much bigger on this barley that's drilled with the Mzuri in comparison to these ones that are a lot smaller with the standard combination drill. Now the benefits of the Mzuri, and why we're trying to push it towards our farmers, is so that we can encourage minimal soil disturbance and encourage people to build up the organic matter in their soils through allowing the previous crop stubbles, or whether it be some sort of turf or a cover crop, to be left on the ground and incorporate those good nutrients that you get from those previous year's crops. Now, the importance of maintaining a good soil structure and building organic matter is that we encourage the ground to retain the moisture, the sediment and any nutrients that have been on the crop for that year. Now, the important part for us in terms of retaining sediments is that we then don't lose them to the watercourse. Now, the watercourse is where the row of trees are at the bottom of this hill. And we have a real issue at the moment with things like manganese and phosphates in the watercourse. And those are all carried via sediment off the field. We particularly encouraged the use of the Mzuri strip tillage drill in this type of crop because spring barley is one of the worst crops for applying or for needing to apply manganese during its growth cycle. And being that it's in such close vicinity to the watercourse, all four fields of the trial, we thought this was essential. Also because before the previous crop was grass, usually if you plough up a grass lay, you're sort of, especially if it's a long-term lay, you're releasing nitrates, which can easily be leached to the watercourse. So by encouraging the farmer to use a minimal till system or no-till system, it's essential for us. But also because the Mzuri leaves the previous crop's roots in the ground, so it doesn't turn over the soil and disturb that rooting that was previously there. So that holds the soil together a lot more than it would do if you turned the soil and ploughed it. So as I mentioned previously, we've seen quite a difference in the size of the heads and the ears of the barley between the two trial crops. So the one on the left hand side, this side, that's the barley drilled with combination drill, and then the ones on this side are the barley drilled with Mzuri. You see they're quite significantly larger, and we've seen that throughout the field actually, where we've done the two different types. So we've been using the Mzuri for a couple of years now up at our trial farm near Uttoxeter. And we've had some good successes with it, I think. I mean, it's definitely a system you need to commit to and do it for a good couple of years to get used to it and see the real benefits from it. So it's not a short-term change. We did struggle with it last winter due to it being so wet, so we couldn't get in as many of our trial crops as we'd like to. But obviously this spring barley was put in the spring this year, and it's been really good. and so far we've seen some real successes with it. So we're sort of aiming to do another couple of crops this year on the trial farm, including winter wheat and spring barley and the cover crops, but I don't think we're going to do the oilseed rape this year with it, just due to the problems with the flea beetle. But certainly going to go and do some more crops on this bit of land, and then hopefully encourage more farmers to use it.